I don't know, what you guys think? Are these enough for a day? So, 10 foods this vegan bodybuilder can't live without. This is my top 10 non-negotiable foods. These are the foods that I eat every single day. Some of them because of the nutritional value and others because I really, really like them because they're really convenient. But these 10 foods make up the majority of my calories. Although some of the foods on this list don't really have that many calories, but okay. Most of the foods in here make up most of my calories. Right now I'm eating 3,700 calories a day, so as you can see, I have a lot of calories to eat. And the number one food on my diet is oats. Oats make up most of my calories for breakfast and for any other meal other than lunch and dinner. So I eat oats every single day. Without oats, my life wouldn't be the same. It's that simple. It's been my breakfast for almost 5 years now, and I eat it for breakfast, I eat it in the middle of the afternoon for my post-workout, sometimes I eat it before going to bed, and even when I don't feel like cooking or I don't have time to cook a real dinner or lunch, I make oats. So you can eat oats in a lot of different ways. I love to make oat porridge because you can add a lot of different fruits, dried fruits, seeds, protein powder, different types of veggie milks, and there's pretty much 1,000 ways to make oat porridge, so that's why I love it so much and I have it every single day, and it's still one of my favorite meals. Next item on the list is flaxseed. If you're vegan and you don't eat flaxseed, chia seed, hemp seed, or walnuts every single day, then you should supplement omega-3 DHA from algae. Seriously, these are the top 4 vegan sources of omega-3s, and other than this, you don't really get a lot of omega-3s in a single meal. Yes, avocados have like a little bit, cashews have a little bit, but it's not enough, especially because we need to keep an omega-6 to omega-3 ratio. So, I've already talked about this and you can look more into it, but if we don't have a good omega-6 to omega-3 ratio, we might not convert ALA from the vegan omega-3 sources to DHA. That's something that we really want. And it can increase inflammation. So the most your ratio should be, the highest is 4 omega-6s to 1 omega-3, but you should actually strive to have 2 omega-6, 1 omega-3, 1, 1. Most of the days I actually have more omega-3s on my diet than omega-6s because I eat at least 30 grams of flaxseed every day, and that just covers all my omegas. That's one of the reasons why eating oil like olive oil or even peanut butter can be bad if you eat too much, because it will mess up your omega-6 to omega-3 ratio. They're really high in omega-6s and low in omega-3s. Okay, next on the list we've got bananas, obviously. Now, there's nothing really super special about bananas. They're not one of the most nutritious foods you can eat. They're actually one of the foods with the highest amount of calories and all, but they are just so convenient. You can eat them in so many ways. You can add them to your porridge, to your shakes, to your smoothies. You can eat them as they come. And they are just amazing. Shout out to Derek. Bananas are amazing. Seriously, you can use bananas in a lot of things and they will make everything taste better. Everything will taste sweeter with bananas. So I have bananas every day with my porridge, and even after my workouts, I have a banana like that. So I pretty much have 2 or 3 bananas a day. Okay, 4th on the list, and this gets a little bit tricky because it's beans, chickpeas and lentils. Okay, I decided to put the 3 of them together because because these are my main sources of protein. Beans, chickpeas and lentils, I have them every single day for dinner or for lunch, sometimes both. I usually cook in batches, so I have the same meal two or three times in a row, but beans are my main source of protein. They are incredibly, incredibly healthy. Doesn't matter what some people out there might say about lectins and the anti-nutrients in beans. No, beans are one of the healthiest foods we should eat. They have a lot of protein, so that makes them a good protein source, but they are also super high in micronutrients, vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, phytonutrients, all of that, so eat your beans. They are the number one predictor of life expectancy in old age. Every single population on the planet that lives up to 100, that has a higher than average life expectancy, eats beans. Look up the Blue Zones, Okinawa, Sardinia in Italy. They all eat beans on a consistent basis, even here in Portugal in the Mediterranean diet. Okay, in fifth place we got rice, whole wheat pasta, and potatoes, including sweet potatoes. These three, along with oats, make up probably 40 to 50% of my calories. As you know, most of our calories should be coming from carbs. They're our body's favorite energy source. That's what fuels our workouts. So eat a lot of carbs. Personally, I eat between 50 and 60% of my calories from carbs, and most of that is from these four sources. And other than that, it's pretty much just fruit, my other carb source. Okay, in sixth place, we've got broccoli. And it's just that, broccoli. For some reason, I really, really love broccoli. They are one of the best vegetables you should eat. We should eat cruciferous vegetables every day. Cruciferous vegetables are broccoli, cauliflower, red cabbage, Brussels sprouts, even kale. We should be eating a lot of them every single day. They have a compound called sulforaphane that is incredible in fighting cancer. It's one of the top research compounds in foods that help fight cancer. So eat a lot of cruciferous vegetables, but they are also super high in calcium. They do have a pretty good amount of protein. I mean, I eat like 300, 400 grams of broccoli a day, and that's 10, 12 grams of protein, extra protein every single day, and you're not even thinking about it as protein. And if I'm cutting, I may eat like 500, 600 grams of broccoli a day just to have really huge meals. And yeah, you can get a lot of protein with broccoli, and that is my favorite, all-time favorite vegetable, which is weird because I pretty much never ate broccoli until I was like 18 or 17. It's weird. Okay, the seventh on this group is actually protein powder. Now, I know some people don't really like supplements, some people don't like the idea of having to take a supplement. There's nothing magical about protein powder, there's nothing in protein powder that you can't find in food. In fact, eating beans, eating lentils and all of that is better for you than protein powder, because you don't just get protein, you get all of the other nutrients. But protein powder is just so convenient. And that's what you're buying when you buy protein powder. You're buying convenience. So it's easy to just wake up and have 30 grams of protein powder. After your workout, you can take it everywhere. You can put it in smoothies, and you can put it in porridge. You can drink it as it is with a lot of veggie milks. So it's really, really practical and convenient. And that's why I have one scoop of protein powder every single day. As always, if you want to try some protein powder, the best protein powder out there, go for Vivo Life, the brand I work with. You can use my code RP5 to get 10% off. They are carbon neutral, they are raw, they are organic, they test for heavy metals, so they are really the best brand, and they are trying to come out with home compostable package. So I'm also gonna link the Kickstarted campaign down there, so you can join in and help Vivo Life bring compostable package to us all, which is amazing. They're really the best company I could ask for. Next! Okay, the next item on the list is actually turmeric and black pepper. Turmeric is something that you should be having every single day, especially if you're an athlete. Turmeric is incredible in fighting cancer. It's one of the most well-researched compounds out there when it comes to cancer fighting, and it's really, really effective, and it's also a super great anti-inflammatory, so it will help with any inflammation in your body. And as you know, when you work out, you increase inflammation and you want to recover as fast as possible, so have turmeric. And why the black pepper? Because turmeric is not bioavailable. This means that if you have turmeric, it will go through your digestive tract, which is great. Being there still impacts your risk of cancer in your digestive tract, but it doesn't really get into your bloodstream. That's where you want it the most. So you need to increase the bioavailability, and you can do that with black pepper. Black pepper increases turmeric absorption by 1,000 or 2,000%. It's incredible. I can't remember the right number, but it will be here on the screen. And you can also eat turmeric with some source of fat, which will also help the absorption. Next on the list is a very similar one, ginger. I also have ginger every single day. Ginger and turmeric and black pepper are the spices that I have every single day because of the anti-inflammatory effects. There's actually some studies out there that compare ginger to some medicine for anti-inflammation, and ginger beats the medicine out. So you can see how ginger is really, really effective. I have like 10 grams of ginger every day. It also helps with my digestion. So after my dinner, I usually have like 10 grams of ginger. And if I didn't use turmeric and black pepper during my day, I'll just have a shot. Yeah, it doesn't really taste like anything. The ginger is hard though. And the last item on this list is something that is just really my preference, but is coffee. I don't have coffee every single day, but I have it 6 times per week, always before my workouts. So my current workout split is always 3 days on, 1 day off, 3 days on, 1 day off, and I have coffee every single day before my workout. I have been doing that for over 2 years now, and there's nothing wrong with coffee. Coffee is actually really healthy. The problem is when you have too much of it and when you become addicted, because coffee is really addictive. If you spend a day without taking coffee and you get migraines, you get super sleepy, then you might have a problem, and it will be a good idea to stop for a couple of weeks to reset your system. But for me, I don't really get that sleepy or migraines if I don't have coffee, so I'm okay with that. I do notice that it used to hit more. Like, I felt it more before, and I don't feel it a lot now, but I still feel it, and I never increase the quantities, so that's good. If you have to increase the quantities to feel it, then it's time to step back, okay? Guys, that's it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. A little bit different here from the channel. Like the video if you like the video. Let me know down below your top 10 foods that you have to eat or try to eat every single day. And I'm gonna see you all in the next video.